Welcome to the first episode of Terraformation.
It's Terraformations, not Terraformation.
Oh, yeah. Anyway. Put the stop sign down.
Oh, anyway. We're gonna terraform the first planet. Mars.
Beep. Mars is a very dead, cold world. And Earth, we're gonna have to go here sometime. And we're gonna have to transform it. Wait, can we?
Oh, sure we can.
It's obviously not easy, but Mars is totally possible to terraform. My first idea is that the two moons of Mars, Phobos and Deimos, can be easily terraformed, cannot be terraformed. But the thing is, couldn't we just bombard them together?
This would make one ginormously extra large or something.
Actually, no, just twice the mass of,
at least just the mass of both of the moons of Mars combined.
So it's not twice the mass of both moons combined, it's just all the mass. And that means, we'd have to make sure it has a stable orbit around Mars. This would probably keep itself extra, instead of very unwobbly, both masses as one might keep a less of a problem. Well, who knew that? Anyway, so Mars is simple to terraform, right? Not really. Now we have Phobos, which is Phobos plus Deimos. But now we have to transform Mars. So let's get a Mars in here. Mars is actually a lot smaller than Earth. But it has similar because of the tilt and so on. A day is not the same as one Earth day, but it's pretty good for realistic. Anyway, Mars is a very dead kind of thing. But anyway, once we got Phobos going, next we need to increase atmosphere. The atmosphere, we need a magnetic field. Now, where are we going to get the magnetosphere? The magnetosphere is what surrounds our planet and protects it from the solar wind. Earth has one, and it's kind of big. Even Jupiter, Earth ain't the only one with one of these huge magnetospheres. Oops, hold on. Because Earth ain't the only one. It ain't alone. Because did you know that Jupiter and Saturn have ones too? Jupiter's is big. It's the biggest magnetosphere in the entire solar system besides the sun's. And the sun's is even, it's kind of small. Even smaller than the size of Earth. I mean, it's even bigger, not even smaller, but Earth's is a lot smaller. In fact, if you want to see Jupiter's magnetosphere, you can see it, and it would be bigger than the full moon. Yeah, it's that big. But if Mars doesn't have one, why does it have none? Well, probably it lost it because its core just cooled down. It's just not a big planet. But my idea is to put a big ring or something of magnetic stuff. Most of the time, what I was thinking was probably more like a giant magnetic, a bunch of bars, okay? Well, how about that? Well, anyway. But still, that's not enough. So, stop. Don't go there yet. First of all, you need to increase the atmosphere. The easiest way to do this is to just put a bunch of plant life there. Cover Mars and a lot of plant life can be very is not the best way, but it would be work because Mars's atmosphere is carbon dioxide. Therefore, we plants inhale this carbon dioxide, and then they would eventually turn that into oxygen. But hold on, we can't have plants just yet. Mars is too cold. So the best option is to use modern day technology, factories. Place them on separate spots on Mars. And eventually, at this point, we can just, make Mars warmer. But you still can't breathe. That's when we can do the plants. At this point, we can with a magnetosphere, a good-sized moon, and even plant life. And now we're heading straight for oxygen. But now the planet's warm enough, at least 15 degrees Celsius or around there. The ice cap will melt, adding some water to the planet. All we need now is to smash a few comets onto the planet. Huh? Sounds too dangerous for you? Don't worry. If we can smash a comet in a safe spot, this will build up in some water, and at this point we have enough water that we can see a few clouds developing, like so. At this point we can just ship water from the Earth and bring it over to Mars and continue smashing comets. So Earth water plus comets. This will change. Hold on, once more. This would eventually change Mars from a barren wasteland to more of a paradise. It wouldn't look the same as the Earth. So here's Earth now, and here's possibility of the terraforming Mars. So it looks a lot different. And plant life is important. Why? We can use wood. Because once we get wood, we'll be able to plant more trees and make houses. How simple is that? Then we won't have to worry about cutting down all Earth's wood, because now we have another planet with wood. How incredible. And, so there you have it. Why is Mars so hard? Why would Mars be so hard? Thing is, that it would take forever, and plus, it's just too toxic, and so on. But also, what else is on Mars? We have super devastating dust storms. These are so powerful, they can cover the entire planet. Bad enough for you, there are tons of dust devils on Mars too. Yikes. We will have to overcome this. Also, the current rovers. We'd have to save them, basically. And then, at this point, Mars will be habitable. What do you know?
Habitability.
Incredible.
No need to stop sign anymore. Hear that, Earth?
Yes, I did.
Hey-ya.
So in the future, we can just terraform Mars, like I said. But now, this means we will have two little Earths. And,
And this means that we can, that if an asteroid hits the Earth and kills the Earth, we'll still have another planet. And then once Earth eventually heals, by that happens, Mars will be destroyed. But once life comes back on Mars, then Earth will sometime, and so on. Meaning we'll still have life going on. By this point, the next video will terraform the next planet. Which won't be easy at all. Dun dun dun! Hope you enjoyed the video.
Yeah.
Also, expect the next one to come out. Lee, 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 lee! We're planets. Ow.